नमस्ते, दिस इज जेवीएन डॉक्टर विशाल सक्सेना, प्रोफेसर इन मैथमेटिक्स इन फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मैथडोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक अ लेक्चर ऑन द लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन। दिस लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एंड इट्स अ सॉल्यूशन मेथड। So this topic of linear differential equation is from the course Business Mathematics and under the program of BBA and BBA LLB second semester of the university. So in the last lecture we have discussed about the homogeneous differential equation and the variable separable form. So the linear differential equation of first order is to be taken today, and what is its concept, how to solve the linear differential equation, and just we will take one example to explain this method. So first of all, linear differential equation means it is a kind of differential equation which is in the form of dy by dx plus py is equal to q. So look at this term here, dy by dx means a derivative term of a dependent variable y, and this is a function of x. So dy by dx, first order linear differential equation is presented there, and dy by dx is the first derivative term, and plus py, a term of y should be there, it must be there. Means that what is condition of linear differential equation? It is dy by dx term should be there, and the other terms, the other coefficients p and q are there. These are the either constants or maybe the function of x. So remember this, p and q may be the numeric constants or the functions in x. Function in x means these can be in any different way and any different form, like sine x, cos x, log x, tan x, e raised to the power x, or whatever the other form, maybe in algebraic form p and q, or maybe both constant functions. So this kind of equation is called linear differential equation, sir, and it consists of a y and a derivative of y. The differential equation is a first order differential equation, it is called the first order linear differential equation. Okay, so this linear differential equation means where the derivative term dy by dx and the term of y must be in the degree 1. First we have to understand what is the concept of linear. Linear means where the variable y and its derivative term is just having the degree, having its exponent as 1, then it is called a linear differential equation. Now more specifically, the linear differential equation can be presented in one more way, that is called a dx by dy. So look at here, just the two different forms of linear differential equations are mentioned there. One we have already discussed, dy by dx plus py equal to q, and just here p and q are the constants or maybe the functions of x. Why it is these are the functions of x? Because x in this equation is the independent variable. In the second form, the linear differential equation can also be given way in this way, dx upon dy plus p1x equal to q1. So just we can see in this equation x is coming in numerator, and that's why x is the function of y. So x is the dependent variable, x is the unknown function, and it is a function of y. So definitely the two terms of p1 and q1 in this equation, these are either constants or maybe the function of y alone. Okay, so just these are function of x, these are the function of y or maybe the constant terms. So that is called the second form of linear differential equation. And now what is method to solve this equation? So, but before this, here we take some example to of these two forms. So, look at here, first example, dy by dx plus y is equal to cos x. So, first we have to see whether this equation is in that particular form for the linear differential equation or not. So what is linear differential equation means, form, there should be a term of dy by dx that is just coming here, and one is a term of y. So y is also there. The rest p and q, p means the coefficient of y, and q means the right hand side term. These may be either constants or maybe the function of x. P is there one and q is there cos x. That is correct because always in that equation p and q should be the function of independent variable or the constant. So that is the linear differential equation. The second linear differential equation is given that dy by dx plus minus 2y by x is equal to x square into e raised to the power x. So again we can see there is a term of dy by dx, and a term of y is there, and the value of p is there minus 2 upon x, and the q is x square e to the power x, and therefore again it is a linear differential equation. The linear differential equation in the second form, look at this one, dx upon dy plus x is equal to sine y. That is the second form of the linear differential equation, where just the derivative is coming in the form of dx upon dy and one term of x. Now, definitely p and q, what is p in this first example? P is 1 there and q is sine y. So p and q may be constants or may be the function of y only. So therefore, just sine y is function of y. So that is the linear differential equation. Second point, second example is dx upon dy plus x by y is equal to e to the power y. So dx upon dy plus x upon y. So x upon y means there's a term of x and 1 upon y, and this equal to e to the power y. So what is p there? P means 1 upon y and q means e to the power y, and again this is the linear differential equation. Now, what is method to get the solution, to get the general solution of a linear differential equation? So first, we discuss for the linear differential equation, and this is linear differential equation written in the form of like dy by dx plus py equal to q. So dy by dx plus this one as so method to solve a linear differential equation. So it means that the general solution of differential equation dy by dx plus py is equal to q. Just this one as dy by dx plus py is equal to q is as follows, y into integrating factor, and this equal to in integration q into integrating factor dx plus c. And what is meaning of integrating factor? Integrating factor means e raised to the power p dx. E raised to the power p dx, and that is the integrating factor. Now we take the steps for the solution of a linear differential equation. So just we see this one. Simplify and write the given differential equation in the form of dy by dx plus py equal to q. First of all, see this one. This is the given differential equation. Dy by dx plus py is equal to q. That is the first form linear differential equation where p and q are the constants or functions of x alone. Next, find the integrating factor. Integrating factor in this equation, in this linear differential equation, is given by e raised to the power p dx, e raised to the power integration p dx. So that is the formula for the integrating factor, e raised to the power p dx. And after finding the integrating factor, we have to find its a general solution. And the general solution is given by y into integrating factor. Just by we are taking y, y means the unknown function, because our given differential equation is dy by dx plus py equal to q. So here y is the dependent variable, and therefore the solution is given by y into integrating factor is equal to integration q into if dx plus c. If our differential equation is in the form of dx upon dy, look at here, just I'm again show you this. I will show you dx upon dy plus px equal to q. That is the second form of linear differential equation. Then what is solution of this one? First, we have to find the integrating factor for this linear differential equation, because here in this form the dependent variable is x. Therefore, the integrating factor is given by e raised to the power p dy. E to the power p dy is the integrating factor, and the general solution is given by its a general solution is given by x into integrating factor. So x into integrating factor, x into integrating factor means because x is the dependent variable there. Therefore, this is called the formula for the general solution, and that is consisting here the dependent variable x multiplied with the integrating factor, and this equals to the in integration q. Q means the right hand side term of given equation into integrating factor dy plus c. So that is the general formula for the solution for the linear differential equation for the second form. Now next we take one example to explain this here, just how to solve a linear differential equation or how to apply this method. So look at this given differential equation. Find the general solution of the differential equation is x dy minus y plus 2x square into dx equal to 0. In this given equation, it is difficult to say that this is in the linear differential equation form. Right now, just by this form, we are unable to say that it is the linear differential equation. First, we have to arrange this linear this equation in a proper form of the linear differential equation, and then we have to apply the its method. So it is very important for just before the starting the solution, first you have to check whether the given equation is linear or not, like homogeneous or not, and the other differential equation form. So first reduce this equation in a different in a proper format of the linear differential equation, and that is given here. So just see this form dy by dx. It is dy by dx minus y upon x, and this equal to 2x. How can we obtain this one? In the given equation, first I have divided the whole equation by x. So just what is coming there? Dy minus y plus 2x square by x into dx equal to 0, and then bring this dx in the denominator. So ultimately the equation will become in the form dy by dx minus y upon x equal to 2x, and therefore this equation clearly shows the linear differential equation form. So when it is confirmed, or when it becomes in the linear differential equation form, so now we have to start our method of solution. And first we have to see what are the values of p and q. P means here the term, the coefficient of y. So which is here minus 1 upon x, that is p. What is q there? Q means the right hand side term, that is 2x. Okay, so just p and q are just obtained, and now we have to find its next term, that is the integrating factor. Integrating factor in this method is given by e raised to the power integration sign p dx, e to the power integration p dx, and what is p there? Minus 1 upon x. P is minus 1 upon x dx, so this equals to e to the power minus log x, and this will be equal to, finally, on simplifying this term, it becomes 1 by x. Because when you bring this negative, in the as x, then x becomes x inverse, and finally log and e will cancel out by each other, and finally it becomes x inverse, and which can also be written in the form of 1 by x. So this is integrating factor. Now we have to use our general formula for the linear differential equation, and that is y into integrating factor. Y means that is the dependent variable, and you can see in the given equation, look at this one, y is the dependent variable, that is the unknown function. So y into integrating factor, that is 1 by x, is equals to, in the integration sign, we have to write there q into if. What is q there? I have written already this one. Q means 2x. Q is 2x. Then integrating factor if is to be multiplied there, 1 by x dx plus c. So finally, this term becomes 2x into 1 upon x dx plus c. And now simplify this term, because ultimately we have to perform this integration, and x will cancel out. And then finally, what now becomes? It becomes 2 dx, and this 2 dx. So this will be here 2 dx in integration, and its integral is given by 2x. And plus c, definitely, because this is the indefinite integral, so a constant of integration must be always added in the side of the independent variable. Therefore, its solution is given by y by x is equal to 2x plus c. And if it is possible to separate the unknown function or the dependent variable y, then it is advised to separate this dependent variable y or unknown function, because that is the right form to give the answer. So finally, y is equal to 2x square plus xc, and this is the general solution of our given linear differential equation. So in the today's lecture, we have discussed about the linear differential equation, what is meaning of linear differential equation, what are the its forms, different forms of linear differential equation. We have just divided into two different forms, and then we have just shown here the method by which a linear differential equation can be solved, and we have discussed with one example. So students are just sub, to students are advised for practice, because in mathematics it is always required practice. So do practice for such questions, and with this I am concluding today's lecture. Thank you.